Hello everyone and welcome to my video about high performing. As end of September 2022, this is the latest update for high performs and how to build them properly. For beginners, to explain what the high perform is, it's basically an account made just for the production of a singular resource. And this is the most effective way of getting a lot of resources in a quick period of time. It minimizes the need for gathering, but it takes quite some time to optimize it. Making 4 of them should be enough to cover every resource you may need in the future. And this should contain enough information for you to build a good hyperfarm. Before we get into it, a small tip is that you can do this for your main account as well. If you don't want 4 accounts and you think it's too time consuming to make 4, you can make just 3 and your main covers another resource type. Without the gold, of course, if you plan on fighting, and the grain will not be possible until you reach Sheila 4 stars and this boots the gold and use this item from the Sept of the Seven. Now, let's get into it. So there are 4 kinds of hyperfarms, as mentioned before, namely grain here, wood, stone, iron, each needing different commanders, equipment, castle skins, talents, buildings, and research. In this video, I will cover all of them, and these are the timestamps to skip to the one you're looking for, just in case you don't have enough time. Please note that every hyper farm will have gold included, so that part is extra at the end of the video together with the resource transfer part. Let's start with general tips so that there won't be too many repetitions in the video. Research for grain, wood, stone and iron is found in here in the production tab. If you plan on attacking the account, I do not recommend upgrading this and neither the warehouse. And in this tab you can find the production percentage that each farm will need upgraded basically. And until you get Grand Macer at 25, you will be stuck on this. And it's gonna take a while to upgrade it, but it's really really worth it if you can. Then in the commandership tab you got the capacity. And you can upgrade it up to 30% if, again, you have Grandmaster 25. And you can get Grandmaster 25 by doing training grounds as soon as possible. You will need a lot of diamonds, and I've put the graph on the screen now. Training grounds provides a good amount of diamonds to upgrade, and do not be afraid of using the diamonds at all. It also helps with bubbles and with everything you may need on the farm. Next tip is from the Sept of the Seven, you can increase your production using a scroll, including for gold as well. You can buy these with alliance coins and diamonds, preferably alliance coins, because diamonds you will need a lot of them. You can increase them for 25% for 24 hours or for 7 days. The only downside would be that you have to remember to reconnect on the farm and put it on. Next tip is talent points. Most of the beginners will know this, but you can basically get talent points when leveling up and when upgrading your castle. You can see it here. And I will put the talents for the specific hyper farm when it comes to it, like post them on the screen, and you will just have to copy them. Next up is the blacksmith. You will need this later on after you upgraded everything basically. It enables you to put one more piece of equipment on your lord so that you get more production, but this is not really that necessary early on, so just keep this in mind for later after you upgrade almost everything. The equipment parts you need to focus on are the Maester set. This gives a lot of gold production after you upgrade it a bit, and it also helps you finish your research faster. The Builder set also gives a lot of production and building speed, and as well as this hammer giving gold production, which you will need on every hyper farm. as well as this in the champion set, giving gold production and research speed. And in the rebels end set, you have this giving gold production and this as well. But basically you need to focus on these. And now it's finally time to start with the hyperfarms. And let's start with the grain hyperfarms. They need the following commanders, and basically if you get them gold without awakening, they give 200% grain production. And you can awaken Sheila for 3 stars, and then she gives 60% more, making it a total of 260 grain production. The buildings should be all farmlands instead of lumber yards like here. And the castle skins, there are none for now, but watch out in the anniversary events, maybe something will come up that's also free. And for the equipment, you need these two pieces for more production. Next up are the wood hyperfarms. The commanders are these on the screen, and just as before, they give 100% when fully awakened to gold. And this time both of them can be awakened, and you get a total of 320% after they get the 3 star. The buildings should be all lumber like here, and the talents are as shown on the screen now. Equipment, you need these two, and castle skins are these other showing on the screen. The garden cape skin is obtainable in fiery mines, and the lush forest is obtainable in the recruitment pass. Okay, now for the stone hyperfarms, the commanders are Russell, O'Brien, Barrett, and the last two are in the recruitment pass and Weirwood Memories, and you can only get medals from there. Russell is in Weirwood, so you can upgrade him first and slowly catch up with the others as well. In this case, all of them can be awakened, so it's a total of 300% when gold, and then 480% when they all reach 3 stars. The buildings should be all quarry, and the talents are as shown on the screen. Now for the castle skins, you need Garden Keep, which is in Fury Mines, and if you played the game in 2019 or 2020, I believe, you also have this skin here, which gives 17.5% stone production. And if you didn't, then you cannot obtain it anymore, so you just have to get the Garden Keep skin. So the equipment that you need is on the screen right now. Okay, let's continue with the iron hyperfarms. The commanders you need are Meryl, Robert, and Gorel. All of them are obtainable in Weirwood and are able to be awakened to 3 stars to get the extra production. So it's the same as with stone. You have 300% production when everyone is gold and not awakened. And after you awaken them to 3 stars, you get 180% extra, so you get 480% iron production in total. For buildings, you need all mines, the talents are as shown on the screen, as well as the equipment. And for the castle skin, you need Glorious Keep Veil Fortress, which is available to buy at, I believe, 1000 black diamonds. This is the only pay to win skin that it's in the video. Okay, now let's continue with what every hyper farm needs, and that's gold production. For the commanders, you have Rob, Thorin, and Rice. The gold production is at 50% each when gold quality, so 150% total The Awakening is making it up to 210% when 3 stars. The buildings are all mint, and the talents are just like for every other hyperform that was in the video. It's all included there, but I will put them again on the screen. Research, this time it's different than the others. You got nothing that's in production. It's all just for the other resources. You have first informations. You have these two, which are hold capacity and hold production. And at Maester 25, you can upgrade it to 70%. And capacity to 30% as with the others as well. Then you also have in commandership even more gold capacity. This is, I believe, 10%. Yep. And that's the research. Equipment is for maximum gold production is on the screen. And castle skins, there are a lot of them. I've put them on the screen and the way how to obtain them. If there's nothing on there, then I don't know how to do it. So, yeah. Let's move on to the transports. If you don't plan to transport the resources but instead attack the hyper farm, note that the resources lost in form of tax are 30%. So the transport gives more resources back, but it also takes more time to do so. But if you plan to transport them, this is how to do it properly. First, max out your market, get it level 25 as soon as you can. If you want to transport, of course, because this is helping a lot with transport capacity, the speed you do it. It's, I think, 8% tax at max level, and you also get a lot of transport speed when you get 25. And for the resources, you also have a lot to do. You have these, you can get up to 3 million extra if you upgrade this, and this also reduces tax by 1%. It's not that much, and this makes the delivery way faster, so you help yourself in basically not wasting as much time. Then you have in this great city military, you have another two, just 1 million here to obtain, and I believe only another 30%. And again, in the T5 research, you have the movement speed for transport, again 15% extra again. And then further, you have another 1 million you can add for your transport capacity. So you can get a lot of resources out quite fast. And that's it for the video. Give a like if it helped, and share it to anyone that you think they may need it. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.